Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. At long last, here it is, my Gone with the Wind fabric book for my swap. This was challenging, invigorating, and so much fun to create. And I changed it several times because I just wasn't happy with one thing or another. I think I'm happy now. I can let it go. I also have started one for myself, but again, along with the Doggone Gypsy book and my Moulin Rouge book, who knows when I'll finish them. I'll work on them in between other projects, I guess. But this book is 8x8. The page, not including the dangles on the bottom, and the base was 19. Okay, so what I did was I cut a piece of fabric 19 inches long by 8, so 19 by 8. And then it's 6 pages, so I cut 3 base pages of fabric, 19 by 8. Then what I did was I sewed on this side, I stacked them together, and I sewed down the middle to create the center here, which, let me see if I can show you with the doggone piece of paper. Okay, so, do I have a scrap piece of paper somewhere? Oh, goodness me. I am just never ready. Okay, let's do it like this. So let's say this was 8 by 19, and you get 3 pieces of paper, or 3 pieces of fabric. Then all I did was I measured in 8 inches and folded, right? And I ironed there. And then I measured in 8 inches. So 8 inches from here to here, from here to here, and I ironed, and then 8 inches from here to here, and ironed, and then you lay all 3 pieces of fabric on top of each other, and then you just sew here and sew here. And that's how I created my book. I then cut a piece of chipboard the size of my spine. And because it's open at the top here, you know, when you sew here and here, there's like a little opening there. I stuck the piece of chipboard inside here, you know, like that. And then I sewed here to close it off, and I sewed here to close it off. So that gave me a really, really sturdy binding. And the pages are very flexible. So that's kind of how I did my binding. And this is the side. I've used some shabby rosettes. I used some of this curtaining and gathered. I used some golden lace fabric, and I used this particular lace, and this is in my store. I think it's like a 6-inch long lace, and let me see if I can show you a piece of it. I received so many of these types of dangles for my challenge that's what I used in the book here to line, because I had the most of that. So this is that lace, from my store that I use down here. This is a green tea dyed applique. These are little bits here, here, and here, and the sequins, and here, of my favorite wedding applique right here as well. This is my favorite wedding dress applique, and it is, I absolutely love this. It happens to get on every single one of my projects, and I share it whenever I do swaps. Let me see if I can get a bigger piece so you can look at it. And I have shared bits of this. Yep, there we go. absolutely gorgeous. I cut these little flowers out all the time. All I do is just glue the backs, and that's what those little bits are. So I used that. That's one of my wedding dress appliques. This page is kind of full of goodies from my store. This one, this flower trim is a lace. I think I sold out. And this one is in my store. This organza flowers in my store. This is not. This one I got from Frog Feathers quite a long time ago. Frog Feathers store. This was a piece of the of a curtain. I think Nola gave me this one, or maybe someone else gave me a piece of curtain, and I want to say it was Deborah Eves who gave that to me. That is an applique from my store. More of the wedding dress. This is just one of these made out of the curtaining. And a little rosette. This beautiful box pleated ruffled organza and satin trim was from Carla's S001 when I was a designer for her. So I used that. Oh, goodness gracious. All the way around. In the back, I put an applique. Try to get this whole thing in frame. An applique with the little bits here and there of that wedding dress. And then more of this trim and rhinestones. And then on the bottom, I added little beaded trim. I hand beaded these little seed beads. And yeah, I think that's all I did. Yep, I think that's all I did for that. I left some plain. So I didn't want it to get too crazy. So that's the bottom. That's the side. And that's the top. And the way it lays, it sits. I didn't have to put a closure because it sits pretty straight. When I do a fabric book this big, I really try to make sure that it lays flat. And with that type of binding, it's really easy to do that, have it lay flat. Okay, let's get inside. What's our time? obviously I used photos from Gone with the Wind, and the way I did the photos, I don't have a printer, but I do the photos by taking a CD to Staples with the photos, and then I, let me see if I can find something to put behind here to lean on. Okay. And then I try to, then I iron them on to fabric. This is really hard to film. Okay, so I know what we'll do. Let's do this page first. Okay. This was the whole base of fabric that I used was fabric from Gale Fava 4. And then this blue fabric here and here. And some of this fabric over here, all this blue fabric, this one, the bow, this one, and this one, are all a piece of a dress that Gail Fava Ford gave to me. And what I did was I just cut it out and turned it into a trim and used it on the bottom and on the top. Then I used the gorgeous curtaining to cover the base fabric that Gail gave me. This was from Shoshana 8, which is Susan. And then these little bits of beaded fabric or tulle was another little swatch of like a beaded dress or something. And I just cut it up and used it there. Come on, there you go. Okay, I used it there, there, and there. And all I did was lay some of that curtaining down that Nola shared with me. I used a bunch of strips of fabric, and this was one of my own trims here. And more bits of this fabric. And then this little guy is from Elegant Embellishments, one I used to design for Dee. This is one of those little crocheted pieces that I love to make, and then I just cut them up. It's just a chain, and I just cut it up and add it. These are gathered flowers, and this bling I've had forever. Rolled roses. Just three different little rolled roses clustered there. Or two rolled roses and one gathered. Clustered there. And then again, I've used my wedding dress. Bits of wedding dress. Along here, this trim was from frog feathers that I got quite a long time ago. And across the top, let's see if I can show you. I have little teeny tiny bits of resin pieces. And then, of course, I always need to add my bling, my little rhinestone bling. And then these were little blue rhinestones there. And so I did that all the way across the top. The frame, this particular fabric was from Rosella. It's a vintage fabric that I bought quite a long time ago. And then this white fabric here was from the Paper Bag Lady. And then these little bits here was on a long trim. And I just cut the flowers out. And that one was from an Etsy store. And what was the name of that place? I think she is out of business. I think it was Colleen's. She used to sell really skinny trims like that. And then again down here, I used some of that. Just layers and layers. This was a a poncho. I love to use it because it's so textural. So I put it down. That's a wedding dress applique, coffee dyed wedding applique, and then some of this, and then my rolled roses. I created a bow and just put the blings. This was some of the fiber that I just got from Patricia. Thank you, Patricia. And then I have a little flower bling in there. This is also lace from Gail. And there's the phone. So I am gonna stop here. It's hubby. He's in Trona. And I will call you right back.